Hello class 7th, I welcome you all in today's GK class. I hope you all are fit and fine at your respective homes. So today we are going to start with the chapter 28 of your GK book. Let's get started with it. Yes, so the chapter name is India's Superlatives. In this chapter, identify the pictures of some of India's superlatives with the help of the given clues and write their names in the blanks provided. Now let's read the first point. It is the highest dam in India and one of the highest in the world. It is located in Uttarakhand. So it is Tehri Dam. Very nice. Number two. It is the longest dam of India and situated in Orissa. It is? Yes, Hirakud Dam. Number 3. It is the longest river of India. It flows through Bangladesh and India. It is? River Ganga. Very good. Number 4. It is the largest freshwater lake in India and one of the largest in Asia. It is located in Jammu and Kashmir. So it is? Yes, Wooler Lake. Very nice. Now, number 5th. It is the longest road in India. It is also one of the oldest and longest roads of Asia. It connects Bangladesh and Afghanistan through India. It is Grand Trunk Road. Very good. It is Grand Trunk Road. Number 6. It is the highest motorable road in the world. It is in Leh. It is Khardungla. Very good. Khardungla. Number 7. It is the largest port in India. It is situated in Maharashtra and it is Jawaharlal Nehru Port. Yes. Now, last but not the least, it is the highest airport in India. It is situated in Leh. It is Kushok Bakula Rinpoche Airport. Yes. So this is all about your chapter 28, India's Superlatives. Now let's come to the chapter number 29, which is First Indian Women. So women are a symbol of strength and compassion. Let us see India's first ever achievers in different fields. Identify and fill in the blanks. Number 1. Dash is the first woman prime minister of India and the first Indian woman to receive the Bharat Ratna award. She was also named as Women of Millennium in 1999 by BBC. Yes, any guesses? Very good. It is Indira Gandhi. Yes, Indira Gandhi. Second one. Now, who is the first Indian woman to have received the Nobel Peace Prize? She gave her life to social work. Yes, to social work. Who is the first Indian woman to have received the Nobel Peace Prize? Yes, Mother Teresa. Very nice, Mother Teresa. Come to the third one. Who is the first Indian woman to reach the summit of Mount Everest? She is awarded the Padma Bhushan, the third highest civilian award in 2019. Yes, who is she? Bachendripal. Very good, Bachendripal. Come to the fourth one. Now tell me, who is the first Indian woman to join the Indian Army in 1993? Yes, any guesses? Yes, Priya Jhingan. Very good. Come to the fifth one. Dash is the first Indian woman pilot to fly solo in the Indian Navy in 1994. Who is she? Harita Kaur Deol. Very good. Next, who is the first Indian woman boxer? to win a gold medal in Asian Games 2014. She is also the only boxer to win a medal in each of the six world championships. Yes, who is she? Marie Kom. Very good. Seventh one. Who is the first Indian astronaut to go into space? She died in 2003 in the space shuttle during its re-entry in the Earth's atmosphere. Who is she? Yes, I know. Who is she? Yes, Kalpana Chawla. Very good. Eighth one. Who is the first Indian woman doctor and the first one to obtain a medical degree from the United States? Yes, who is she? Anandi Gopal Joshi. Yes. So we have completed this chapter. Now let's move on further. Chapter number 31, Dances of India. So India is known for its diverse culture. Each culture has its festivals, cuisines, and dances. With the help of the clues given below, write the names of the dances of India. Okay, so the first one is this dance has originated from Tamil Nadu. It is one of the oldest and major dance forms of India. Any guesses? Yes, Bharatanatyam dance. Very nice. Come to the second one. This dance form has originated from Kerala. It is a blend of dance, music, and acting. Eye movement holds a key importance. Yes, which dance form? Kathakali. Very good. Come to the third one. This dance is one of the eight major forms of dance. It narrates a story through facial expressions and body movements. It has originated from Uttar Pradesh. Yes, which dance form? Katha. Very good. Come to the fourth one. It is one of the oldest surviving dance forms of India. It is originated from Odisha. Which dance form it is? Odissi dance. Very good. Next one. This dance is one of the major forms and also the most famous dance forms of northeastern states. It has originated from Manipur. Yes, it is Manipuri dance. Very nice. Come to the sixth one. This dance form has originated from Kerala. It is a classical solo dance form and it is Mohiniyattam. Very good. Number seven. It is a traditional dance form of Punjab. It is generally performed during Baisakhi. During Baisakhi. Which dance form? Bhangra dance. Very nice. Come to the eighth one. It is a state festival of Assam. It is performed to celebrate the harvesting festival. Which dance form it is? Bihu dance. Yes, correct answer. Very nice. Okay, class, now let's come to the ninth one. It is a folk dance of Rajasthan. Its name symbolizes the 12 movements of dancers. So, yes, any guesses? Very good. It is Ghumar dance. Very nice. Now let's come to the next chapter. So this is your chapter number 32, Women Mountaineers. Women are constantly coming in the front to make name for themselves and create history. Let's read about some women mountaineers who have made a mark by conquering mountains. Number first, Bachchendri Pal, become the first Indian woman to reach the summit of Mount Everest in 1984. Despite the criticism from her family, she went to pursue professional mountaineering. She reached the summit on May 23, 1984. 1984, amidst an avalanche, she was awarded the Padma Shri, India's fourth highest civilian award in the same year. The next we have is Arunima Sinha, became the first Indian woman amputee to reach the summit of Mount Everest in 2013. She lost her leg in a horrific accident some years ago, but her disability could not stop her. Apart from that, she has also climbed Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa, Mount Kosciuszko in Australia, Mount Elbrus in Europe, and Mount Aconcagua in South America. She was awarded the Padma Shri in 2015. Next, Premlata Agarwal became India's oldest female mountaineer to have climbed all the several summits. She started her career in the late 30s, and by the late 40s, she has climbed the seven summits. She was conferred with the Padma Shri in 2013. The next is Poorna Malawat became the youngest female mountaineer to reach the summit of Mount Everest. She climbed in 2014 at the age of 13. She also became the youngest girl in the world to have even done this, Poorna directed by Rahul Bose in her biopic. Now, chapter number 34, Earthquakes in India. Earthquake is caused by the sudden release of energy in the Earth's lithosphere, and that creates seismic waves. It causes mild to extreme shaking of the Earth. Let us learn about the most devastating earthquakes of India. So, this earthquake hit Gujarat in January 2001, measuring 7.7 on the Richter scale. It was a massive earthquake that killed 20,000 people and severely damaged the properties and communication system. Bhuj suffered major damages. The next is the earthquake hit Maharashtra in 1993. More than 20,000 people were killed in the devastating earthquake. The epicenter was a village in Latur district. More than 52 villages were razed to the ground. The next is the earthquake hit Bihar in 1934 and is considered the worst quakes in the history of India. It measured 8.0 on the Richter scale. More than 30,000 people were killed. The tremors were felt even Kolkata. On October 20, 1991, the worst earthquake hit Uttarkashi. More than 1,000 people were killed and extensive damage to property was caused. Now, let's come to the next page. Yes, now this is your worksheet 3. Identify the given pictures. Okay, so the first one is Bachendripal. Very good. Second is, it is Manipuri dance form. Third, Victoria Mahal. And number 4, Dead Sea. Very good. Now, the question B says, match each name of the mountain summit to the continent it belongs to. Okay. First is, Mount Kosciuszko belongs to Australia. Yes. Second is, Vincent Massif. It belongs to Antarctica. Number third is Mount Aconcagua. It belongs to, yes, South America. Number fourth, Mount Everest. It belongs to Asia. Number fifth, Mount Kilimanjaro. It belongs to Africa. Number sixth, Mount Elbrus. It belongs to Europe. And last but not the least, Mount McKinley. It belongs to North America. So yes, class 7, that is all about today's class. We have discussed different chapters of your GK book. Thank you. Have a nice day, all of you.